You might be in a pit right now. But I'm going to tell you what, you can come out that pit if you will start putting your faith in the blessing, because no pit can keep you there if you'll keep your faith in the blessing.
Here's the perfect Father's Day special gift idea. Dr. Godot's Fatherhood. It's a double DVD series that helps men be the best dads they can be, and it's only $20. Dr. Godot shows you how to embrace your role as father and be the leaders and mentors God created you to be, something that should never be taken for granted. You'll learn how to have the courage to commit to true fatherhood. This series will help build character in you and your children for generations to come. The Fatherhood Series by Dr. Philip George Godot.
Everything you need is in the blessing. My God, it's in the blessing. The blessing, everything you need is in the blessing. So if I will live my life pleasing to God, God will then put the blessing upon me, and the blessing then will start working for you. The blessings works for you. You're going to see it here in just a minute, and then things will start happening for you. Now the blessing, everybody say the blessing. The blessing also is an enabler. In other words, once I receive the blessing, it enables God to work on your behalf, to cause things to happen for you that would never happen for you before. Amen. See, there's a whole lot of Christians trying to live this Christian life without the blessing upon their life. So they're trying to navigate life's highways in their own ability. And therefore, supernatural things are not happening for them that should be happening for you, because God never intended for you to try to navigate this life's highway on your own ability. Amen. Are y'all with me? Amen. So it's an enabler. It enables God to show up on your behalf. So then I have to, by what? Faith. Come on, by?
Faith.
I have to do by faith, believe that I receive the blessing on my life as a believer by putting my faith in, but putting a demand upon the blessing. Now, watch this here. Sin came and man was put out of the garden. Two things happened upon the man. Number one, sin came, and then the curse came upon mankind. Man was separated from God, and God now had to bring Jesus into the earth realm through generations to be able to redeem man from the curse. From the curse and from sin and hell. Right. So then Jesus is the carrier of the being the redeemer. I am the redeemed of the Lord, and I say so. Are you with me? But then God used Abraham to be the one to be able to be the one who brought the blessing back. Jesus brought and delivered us from the curse of the law. But in Genesis, the 12th chapter, we see that God now is trying to at least give man a chance, an avenue to be able to start having a chance to live victorious by bringing the blessing back on his life. Now look with me in Genesis, 12th chapter. Are you there? In Genesis, the 12th chapter. If you ain't there now and you haven't found Genesis now, you never will probably find it. Genesis 1 and 12. Genesis 12 and 1, I mean. Genesis 12 and 1, it says, and the Lord said unto Abram, get thee out. What did he say?
Get thee out.
Would you underline that in your Bible? And if you can't underline it in your Bible or your iPhone or your iPad, your whatever gadgets you have, but underline it, say, get thee out. Now, look what it says. Get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred, and from that father's house. There's three different things that he had to get away from: his country, his kindred, and his father's house. Why? Because what happened is sometimes when God's blessing starts manifesting in your life, it comes to do what?
Elevate.
Come on, come on. It comes to?
Elevate.
It comes to what?
Elevate.
Elevate you. So in the elevation process, when God's blessing starts manifesting in your life, people will start saying, well, it's because you live there, or because you're around them, or because you have this. Are you, anybody understand what I'm talking about? So they'll start finding some reason to start giving every other reason except saying that God did it.
Amen, Pastor.
So God has to separate you sometimes. Sometimes he's got to separate you from some things where God will get all the glory out of it, and nobody else to get the glory but him, because they have nobody else to blame, because you done got away from your country. You done got away from all your ugly kin folks. No. Because see, God gives you family to teach you how to handle enemies. Families train you how to fight, to deal with your enemies that come up. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Don't be acting like that over here. So he said, get away from your country, from your family, your kinmen, and from your father's house, or from your father, because under them days, the father took care of the kids until they got married. You never left your father's house until you got married. So then, as long as Abraham wasn't married, he had to stay under his father's house, or he stayed under the dowry and the blessing of his father. So God said, I don't want nobody to take the credit for what I'm getting ready to do in your life. So I'm going to take you away from your father, that I can be able to bless you, and then everybody know that it was me that did it, and not because you were around your daddy. Amen. Now, look what it says here in Genesis, and then it says in verse 2, and I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless you, and make your name what?
Great.
And thou shalt be a what?
Blessing.
And thou shalt be a what?
Blessing.
Give it to me in the Amplified Bible. Give it to me in Amplified. And I will make of you a great what?
Nation.
Come on, look at the screen, everybody. And I will make of you a great what?
Nation.
And I will bless you with abundant increase of favor. Look what it says. I'm going to bless you with abundant increase of favor, and I'm going to make your name great, or make your name famous. Now watch this here. I'm going to bless you with abundant increase of favor. Now, I've been around a long time, so I've been hearing people, everybody that's mine, favor, I want favor, favor, I want favor. But what you really want is you want the blessing. Because if you get the
blessing,
come on, you'll get the
favor.
And the favor, and you'll get the promotion, because in the blessing is promotion. In the blessing is deliverance. In the blessing is increase. In the blessing is everything that you need is in the blessing. So when I get the
blessing,
I get the favor. And favor ain't fair. Especially when you got it and your neighbor don't have it. When God's doing everything for you and he's not doing it for nobody else. See, in order to keep the blessing on my life, I got to always watch my attitude.
Come on, Pastor.
You know, you can be a good Christian, but got a funky attitude. Knock, knock. Who's there? Bad attitude. I got a bad attitude, and God will not bless you with a negative, critical, fault-finding attitude. So you got to work on your attitude all the time. Like this lady, this ticket agent, she was selling tickets, and all of a sudden this man came up in the line, and he was mad as a hornet, and he just started screaming and hollering at the ticket agent, screaming and hollering at her, calling her all kind of names, just being very belligerent at this lady. And all of a sudden he walked away in a fit and rage and still fussing. And then the next man in line said, lady, how in the world could you allow that man to talk to you like that and say all those nasty things to you? How could you be so calm? She said, because he's going to Detroit and his luggage is going to Germany.